In this video, we show you how to deploy an auto-scaled BigIP Local Traffic Manager Virtual Edition using a CloudFormation template, or CFT, in Amazon Web Services. If you aren't familiar with CFTs, they are a quick way of spinning up solutions in AWS that you might otherwise have to create manually. And if you aren't familiar with the BigIP LTM, it can significantly improve the security, performance, and availability of your AWS workloads for an enhanced user experience. Here are some useful links, which are also in the description of this video. The idea behind this autoscale CFT is that it creates BigIP VE instances for you, and based on the limits you specify in the template, as traffic through the BigIP to your applications increases, the number of BigIP instances automatically increases accordingly, without manual intervention. When your traffic decreases, the BigIP instances automatically terminate. This solution has a few objects you must configure in AWS before deploying the template. These are a VPC with at least two subnets, each in its own availability zone, an AWS Elastic Load Balancer, which serves traffic to the BigIP VE instances, and an SSH key pair, which you need to access the instances. For more information on these prerequisites and other configuration notes and tips, see the README file on GitHub. Once these are created, you can get right into launching the CFT. You can either launch the template from the AWS Marketplace, or you can go to the F5 Network's GitHub site. In this video, we want to make sure we're getting the very latest F5 supported template, so we launched using the CFT on GitHub. From the F5 Network's GitHub site, click F5 AWS CloudFormation, Supported, Solutions Autoscale, and then LTM. The README file contains useful information, so we suggest reading it before launching the template. Scroll down, and then click the Launch Stack button. Then click Next, and start to fill out the template. First, you can optionally change the stack name, making it easier to find in your list of stacks. The deployment name is appended to all the instances, so you can tell which ones have been created by the template. Next, select the VPC you created as instructed in the prerequisites, and then select the availability zones that contain the subnets you've created, and then select the subnets you created within the availability zones. And note, these are not regions, but zones. The restricted source address is if you want to only allow specific IP addresses to connect to your BigIP VE instances. For this video, we just open it to all addresses. Next, type or copy-paste your AWS Elastic Load Balancer you created. And the last of the prerequisites, you select your SSH key, which you need to connect to the instances. If you want, you can select different AWS instance sizes and BigIP VE throughput level and image types, but we use the defaults in this video. The autoscaling configuration section is where you determine when new instances are created and how many you want to be available for autoscaling. We use the defaults, a minimum of 1 and a maximum of 3 instances. For the scaling thresholds in this video, we set these numbers really low so we can see the instances launch and terminate more quickly. For more information on these thresholds, including a formula for determining the number of bytes, see the README file on GitHub. And you can optionally type a notification email address to be notified when scaling events occur. In the LTM Virtual Service section, we supply the information about our application for the BigIP virtual server and pool. In this scenario, we have a simple app server on port 80, so we paste its DNS name here. If you want to automatically add app or web servers to your BigIP load balancing pool, meaning traffic will go to them without making any manual changes to the BigIP configuration, we would fill out these pool tag values. We don't do that here, but it works great. See the F5 service discovery video on this channel to see this feature in action. In the tagging section, we leave all these tags at the default values. And in the last section of the template, you can choose to send anonymous statistics to F5 networks. These statistics do not capture any personally identifying information, but really help us to improve our templates, so we recommend leaving the default of yes. When you're finished, click Next, and then Next. This checkbox means that you have the appropriate credentials to set some IAM roles and to create an S3 bucket. And when you're ready, click Create. And now we can watch the CFT creating resources. You can see the status says Create in Progress. This process can take about 15 minutes to finish, and the resources might not be available right away, so it's best to wait about 30 minutes or so before starting to dig into things. When it's finished, the status will change to Create Complete. And now we can see what the CFT created. First, from the EC2 dashboard, you can confirm that the auto-scaling group was created. By clicking the Instances tab, you can see that a BIG-IP VE instance was created and added to the group. By default, there are scaling policies that wait 40 minutes to launch a new instance. For this video, we're going to change this value to 2 minutes or 120 seconds. To be clear, AWS is always monitoring the traffic. They always want to know if you're exceeding the limits that you set. This setting just means that after one instance is launched, AWS should wait 2 minutes before launching another instance, and it'll keep doing this until it hits the maximum number of instances you set, which for this video was 3. Now let's look at the AWS Elastic Load Balancer. You can see that the BIG-IP VE instance is here also, and in service, which is what we expect. Traffic is going through the ELB, through the BIG-IP VE, and to the app servers. And finally, we look at the list of instances. Again, we see the BIG-IP VE that was created by the template. Behind the scenes, traffic to the app servers is increasing, and the thresholds set in the CFT have been exceeded. And, in a bit of a time lapse, you can see that AWS is launching the new BIG-IP VE instances to handle the increased traffic. In this case, the most instances it will launch is 3, as we specified when configuring the template. Now, as traffic through the system decreases, you can watch the instances terminate one at a time. And again, we've sped up this part of the video. In this case, we set the minimum number of instances to 1, so that last instance will always remain active. For more information about the autoscaling BIG-IP LTM VE in AWS template, read the documentation on GitHub or ask questions on our Slack channel at f5cloudsolutions.slack.com. And finally, for more information about configuring the useful features on the BIG-IP LTM, see the LTM documentation on askf5.com. Thanks for watching.